better hit that subscribe button.
All right, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen of the internet and YouTube? I'm Freddy Fuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, Multiplat Game Trap, the people's voice, and your favorite average gamer. Going to be doing a product review. This is something that I unboxed. Link will be in the comment section for the unboxing of this product. What I have behind me is the Vizio M501 A2R Smart TV with Theater 3D. It has a game mode. It has a HDTV tuner. As you can see, we have some apps behind me, which the TV comes pre-installed. It does firmware updates via the Ethernet port or the N Wi-Fi card that's built into it. You have YouTube, Netflix, Hulu Plus, Twitter, Facebook, Rhapsody. I mean, these are just the features, and these are my apps, what I actually have on there. You'll see the ones that are locked. Those are basically settings that you can't delete. I have Amazon Instant Video, which is for my Amazon Prime account, Voodoo Movies, Crackle, Revision 3, YouTube, Twitter, web videos, which are, that has Crunchyroll, all types of stuff in there, then Netflix. And it's pretty snappy, man. I mean, unlike the last ones. All right, now go into here and just do web videos. You'll see it pop up on there. Depending on the app, is you'll either have this type of view or you'll have the huge big view. You got channels, and this is just one of the apps that's on there. Just to show you, you got, you know, Lifetime, Showtime, TV Guide, Revision 3, TMZ, A&E, like I said, Crunchyroll, College Humor, all types of stuff on this. So basically, you know, Media Hub. You can actually stick USB hard drives to it. It'll read movies, videos, pictures. And of course, you know, use a FAT32 format on the hard drive. The picture quality is pretty good. I give it a 8.5 out of 10. And this is for 2014 technology, 2013 technology. Because of it's side lit, it's not edge lit. So the panels light from the left and right. And I found that sometimes you'll catch flicker, or I use the auto dimming technology, which you'll actually see. And here I'll go into the menus, and you'll see the different menus. You got picture, audio, timers, basically go to sleep, you know, guide setup, your system. It'll tell you what your system's actually playing at, you know, 1080p, blah, blah, blah. Right now, since it's in the app, it's not actually doing any type of resolution being fed to it. That's just the app resolution. So if I was to, I just hook it up, it turns on the PS4, turn it off. When you turn off the TV, it'll turn it off via the CEC. You know, it just transmits the signal through the HDMI cable. All right. The menus consist of picture, like I said, and you got different settings. And then you have the custom set, you know. I put it on game mode. Game mode is to reduce as much post-processing from the TV so you can get that low latency feel like you get on plasmas. So this actually improves my gameplay when I play in anything because of the low latency time. I believe it's like 4 milliseconds, 0.04 milliseconds, if I'm not mistaken, on this TV. And then, you know, then you have all the post-processing stuff and advanced pictures, you know, the auto brightness, black details, smart dimming, smooth motion. Even though it does reduce it, I believe it goes from 240 hertz to 120 hertz, or maybe even 60 hertz, when it's doing, you know, in the game mode, or I don't know how they cancel out the latency, but you still have these functions on there. Some TVs, when you put it in game mode, you'll see the smooth, you know, the smooth motion effects taken off. You won't even be able to select it. On this one, you can. Then you have the 3D option. The 3D option, where is it at? All right, you got a, this is actually a backlit LED controller that comes with it. Got Amazon, Netflix, Amigo, actually right on there. See if I press it, you'll see the Amazon video pop up. All right, but the 3D, it'll ask you what it is. It doesn't turn anything from 2D to 3D, from what I know. The output, you got three different SBS, side by side, top, you know, top bottom, and then Senso 3D. And it does that. I actually have some 3D glasses, and I'll let you know if that works. That doesn't work. It doesn't turn 2D signals into 3D. So go back to 2D. Bam, it's in there. But you have games that have 3D that are on a PS4. Like, the only game that I know that's 3D right now would be Zen Pinball 2. That actually asks you to, once you connect it, right now the PlayStation 4 doesn't support, yes. So now it's in 3D, and you'll see it looking kind of pixelated on the corners, because it's actually in 3D. And this actually works on there. It's a passive 3D. It's cinema, you know, cinema polarized glasses in 3D. It's not the active shutters that actually give you more of a headache. So. That's how that 3D works, just like the technology in the movie theaters. You got polarized glasses, as actually looks a lot better than active shutter 3D. It is a 10 million dynamic contrast ratio to 1. So the colors pop, they're vibrant. It just looks great, incredible. I have a 240 hertz in my living room that's a Vizio as well, but it's actually back panel lit. That's the only thing that has an advantage on. But even so, this looks better than the other one that's backlit panel, and it has 680 different backlit LED panels back there. This one actually just side lit. It's very good. It's very inexpensive. I actually got this for, I believe, $750. At the time, it's a 50 inch. They come in 45 inch or 46 or 45 inch, 50 inch, 55 inch, 65 inch. As you can see, there's really no bevel on here. It's just thing where they actually have the adhesive to pull the panel down. So from edge to there, you got maybe a quarter to a half inch between where the screen actually starts, but it all looks like, you know, glass to edge. I'm going to pick up the camera right now and show you this. It is about half an inch thick, and you can see on the back you have different things. I'm gonna swivel it out. I actually have it stuck to the wall. You see the different the components, two USB cables, an extra HDMI cable right here on the side. You got three on the bottom. You got a optical cable out, audio out, you know, the red and white out. Then you have Ethernet over here, and then you have the two speakers that are in the back. They're back speakers right there, and then the power button. The only thing wrong with this TV
when it comes to if your controller dies, no batteries, has no buttons nowhere for any controls on the TV. It is basically, you know, you're just basically out of fucking gas. Here. So, that being said, make sure you keep your controller. The controller is a, you know, IR, and it takes two AA batteries. I got some rechargeables in there. Closes up. So, very snappy. Has for Blu-ray disc players, you know, those colored buttons, the yellow, green, red, and blue. Then 3D picture size, you could change it on the fly. And it's actually controlling both of my screens that there too. They're both Vizios. Channel. The Vizio button does the apps. You know, mute, volume, exit, back, info button tells you what's on the screen. If you want to get more info, well, back. It is system. There you go. It says 1920 by 1080 at 60 hertz. Progressive, yes. Channels, all that good stuff. It's all on there. MAC address, blah, 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 blah. All right. Now, like I said, these are the apps that I have installed. And they work really good. Hey, Vudu. Loading up. You know, my Vudu. It's my thing. I'll just... And this will be really quick. You just see that loads up quick. And back. All right. Now watch. The connection on here is system info. I could do a network speed test. So start test. You see right there, it's just, bam, testing in progress. It's already all the way green. My connection at home is 50 plus megabytes download, 25 plus megabytes upload, so this has no problems with anything. Same thing with the PS4. So I just hit exit. It also lets you use with the CEC from, you know, hooking it up when you go into systems. CEC, enable system audio control. So now, as you can see, I'm using the remote. Why you don't see no flickering on the screen or anything like that, it's because it's more than 60 hertz on the camera, so you don't see no flickering. If you look at the bottom right there, that's a 60 hertz TV and it's flickering. You can use this. Sometimes it stops working depending on what app you're using. So but you can use this for some things. The remote. This is the end of the review, and this is where I give the TV the score, and I'm going to give it a solid 9 out of 10. Great value, great price point, a lot of technology stuffed in this TV. A lot of the parts are made, even though it's a Vizio, either usually made or by Sony or LG or big companies. This happens to be an LG panel
on this TV. So you got a lot of technology, great picture, awesome 10,000,000-to-1 contrast ratio that makes the pictures pop, lively color, rich blacks, nice whites. You have the connectivity, which is gives you two different options. And it's got Wi-Fi end card in it. It has Ethernet port. It has a lot of ports in the back for, you know, devices to be put input. Two USB, which you could power devices through via the USB, or you could set up an external hard drive, flash drives to do video and all that good stuff. This gets a 9 out of 10. This is the M-Audio 501A2R smart TV. It was released in 2013, manufactured by Vizio, obviously. I've said that quite a bit. So, all in all, I love this TV. The only thing that I wish different is they had buttons to control the TV, actually on the TV, other than a power button and change the, you know, the inputs. That's the only type of buttons that you'll find on this TV that has no other TV, so it has no other buttons. So you need this controller, this controller. If this breaks, you need to buy a universal remote control or a replacement. Go to the website and get a replacement. And that it's side lit. It's not edge lit, and it's not back lit. It's side lit. Those are the only two gripes I have on it. Not I would give it a perfect score. And, you know, people don't like Vizio for some reason. Hey, look, man, if you have a budget and you don't want to waste money and you want a lot of technology and you want a great product and they last long, I've had three Vizios. None of them, well, actually, I have four Vizios. None of them ever broke on me. I've had two Samsung smart TVs and they both conked out on me. They both broken on me. I know somebody else that had one, 65-inch, and even his ended up breaking at least once. So for me, even though it's not a most luxurious the company, Vizio, they do offer great TVs for a great price, and they actually going to be offering a 4K 50-inch TV, smart TV, reference TV, this year for $1,000, for under $1,000, so probably $999.99. That's why they say under $1,000. If you want to catch that, go to their website, and they showed it off at CES, I believe, and it looked like a great TV. It had a whole bunch of things. This megahertz on that thing is beast. So that's it, man. That's the review for it. I appreciate y'all watching it. This video has been edited for time and for your viewing pleasure. None of this is scripted that I do, so that's it, man. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Remember to thumb up the video if you like it, thumb it down if you didn't, comment giving your reasons why, or just, you know, saying you got the TV or you like the TV or you're planning to get on it or stuff like that. Facebook, Twitter, Google+, links are in the description. If you're a gamer and you like, you know, gaming subject matter or electronics or anything like that, join the Facebook group, Multiplat Game Trap. Link will be in the description. You can also follow me on Twitter. Like the Facebook page. All the links will be in the description. Catch my last four videos in the description. And subscribe if you haven't already and you want to catch more videos like this. I've been your host, your commentator, Freddy Fuego, Flaming Hot Entertainment, Multiplat Game Trap, the people's voice, and your favorite average gamer. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming.
Thumb up the video, fool!